everyone. I'm Norman Wildberger, a soon-to-be-retired professor of mathematics at UNSW, Sydney, Australia. And here I'm going to tell you about this channel, which will introduce you to a wide variety of mathematical topics from a rather novel point of view. So the content is aimed at a wide audience, from the general public to graduate students doing PhDs in the subject. And a link to this introductory video will be below so that you can quickly find the various playlists that I'm going to be describing. So I believe that mathematics should be completely clear and straightforward, and that ideally a beginner should be able to navigate through the subject one step at a time, supported by lots of explicit examples and computations, with a logical structure visible at all times. But that means that I no longer buy the standard religion of real numbers, which are anchored in an arithmetic reliant on infinite processes. It's not possible to add up an infinite number of things, so why do we pretend that we can? I also don't believe in the hierarchies of infinite sets that supposedly form the foundation of modern pure mathematics following Cantor. It's not possible to exhibit a set with an infinite number of elements. So why do we pretend that we can? The pure mathematical community depends on these and other fancies to support a range of theories that appear pleasant but are not actually corresponding to reality, and theorems which are not logically correct. Measure theory is a good example. This is a subject in which the majority of results are without computational substantiation. And the fundamental theorem of algebra is a good example of a result which is in direct contradiction to computational experience. How do you factor x to the 7 plus x minus 2 into linear and quadratic factors? Answer: you can't actually do it. You can only do it approximately. By removing ourselves from the seductive but false dreamings of modern pure mathematics, we open our eyes to a more computational, logical, and attractive mathematics, where everything is above board, where computations actually finish in a finite amount of time, and where examples can be laid out completely, and where we acknowledge the proper distinction between the exact and the only approximate. This is a pure mathematics that's closer to applied mathematics and more likely to be able to support it. It also gives us many new insights, more precise definitions, and theorems which are actually correct. So in this channel, we begin to explore new ways of learning and doing and teaching mathematics. I present you with topics that are developed and explored in a sequence of YouTube videos, usually from rather elementary beginnings. The topics are organized in playlists, so you can work your way through them sequentially and strengthen your understanding slowly and steadily. The History of Math series is great for high school teachers and anyone with a general interest in mathematics. The subject makes a lot more sense when viewed in a historical context. There's also a playlist on ancient mathematics and another on old Babylonian mathematics. The latter topic is rather close to my heart. A paper in Historia Mathematica a few years ago with Daniel Mansfield on Plimpton 322 generated international coverage in hundreds of newspapers and magazines, including the New York Times. Wild Trig is an introduction to rational trigonometry, a more general and algebraic view of trigonometry that allows more extensive and quicker calculations for many problems, and that opens the door to many new theoretical possibilities, such as chromogeometry. This is all based on my book, Divine Proportions, Rational Trigonometry to Universal Geometry. Famous Math Problems discusses a wide range of famous math problems, some of them with novel solutions. Wildlin-Alg A and the follow-up Wildlin-Alg B are my introduction to an undergraduate course in linear algebra from largely a geometrical point of view. The most extensive series is the Math Foundations series, which comes in parts Math Foundations A, videos 1 to 79, Math Foundations B, videos 80 to 149, and Math Foundations C, videos 150 to the present. This series examines so many important topics in the subject. The most recent videos, for example, give a new treatment of the algebra of Boole, transcending the more usual Boolean algebra, which is not really what Boole intended, and opens the door for simpler logic gate analysis by engineers. The most elementary series is Elementary Math K to 6 Explained, which is for parents and teachers of primary school students, and will give you tools to understand the important mathematical skills and concepts children need to learn mathematics. In this direction, there's also a course on math terminology for incoming uni students, meant for people from a non-English speaking background. Universal Hyperbolic Geometry is a more advanced series on geometry, which will give you an exciting, new, completely algebraic way to understand the hyperbolic geometry of Gauss, Lobachevsky, and Bolyai, and which connects more naturally with relativistic physics. There are hundreds of new theorems here, many very beautiful. I will be developing this a lot more in coming years. There are also more advanced courses on differential geometry and algebraic topology. And there's a quick and more elementary course which introduces probability and statistics. So this is a large amount of content that is consistently oriented towards avoiding infinite processes and arguments which are not supported by explicit computation. It is a new kind of mathematics. If you work through some of this, your mathematical understanding will deepen. You will see connections that were invisible, and your appreciation for the logical beauty of the subject will continue to grow. Mathematics is surely the richest intellectual discipline, and I want to empower more people, young and old, to experience it directly, to learn lots of fascinating things, to be challenged, and to explore on your own. For those of you aspiring to do some research on your own, there will be plenty of new directions to think about. So my understanding is very different from my fellow mathematicians. So why do I have such a unique perspective? One reason is that I have simply worked in lots of areas of mathematics. I've done work in number theory, developing the most powerful general algorithm for solving large Diophantine equations and unraveling the algebraic structure of Gaussian periods. I've done work on Pell's equation, basically discovered the simplest explanation of why solutions are always possible. I've worked in Lie group harmonic analysis, solving the Horn conjecture with A.H. Dooley and Joe Repka on eigenvalues of sums of Hermitian matrices. I've initiated the moment map of a Lie group representation and found a geometric Fourier transform which explains star products on coadjoint orbits of compact Lie groups. And the wrapping map introduced with Tony Dooley gives a broad explanation for the effectiveness of A.A. Kirilov's orbit theory. Now, this may not make a lot of sense to many of you, but I'm just giving you the sort of highbrow, summary of some of my mathematical researches. In work with Didier Arnal, I've introduced quasi-standard Young tableau, building from my geometric diamond construction of the irreducible representations of SU3, which are very important for physicists. I've also given combinatorial constructions for G2 and the simply laced Lie algebras excluding E8. In 2005, I wrote my book and then extended that to a complete rewrite of hyperbolic geometry. This gives a large-scale revision of Euclidean and non-Euclidean metrical geometries. And with this, I have further discovered a remarkable threefold symmetry in planar geometry called chromogeometry. I've developed the theory of finite-signed hypergroups, which are probabilistic versions of finite groups, and developed a duality theory for them, somewhat like Pointer-Jagen duality for abelian groups, and also applied ideas of entropy to them. And for the last 5 years, I've been developing the algebraic calculus, which is a coherent approach to calculus which avoids real numbers and infinite processes and is correspondingly more general and often gives wonderful new insights. Videos for this can be found at the sister channel, Wild Egg Mathematics Courses, while the course itself is on open learning. You can join. So if you're interested in learning more about my research at this more advanced level, there is a playlist on the channel of math seminars and also a smaller one on research snapshots, which I hope to enlarge in the future. On the teaching side, I've Vice Chancellor's Award at the University of New South Wales for Teaching Excellence and have been very involved in the development of online tutorials for mathematics courses there. So in summary, my aim is to put this wealth of research and teaching experience to work in framing a more fruitful path for mathematics education and opening up a more solid approach to pure mathematics research, connected more strongly to computational reality. Come along and join me on an exciting journey to explore new and better foundations and directions for 21st century pure mathematics. Once we face the music and see things as they really are, not just how we want them to be, there is much to do. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.